Today we're going to talk about ground faults on fire alarms, what causes them, how to isolate it inside the fire panel, and then how to troubleshoot it out in the field or in the building. So let's take a closer look at a few things. A ground fault is when current is leaking from a fire alarm conductor to earth ground. Earth ground is typically the electrical boxes. It's the third prong on your plug. If you have metal water pipes, those are typically an earth ground building that's made of steel frame. The steel is a ground. So what can happen is inside of a electrical box or maybe above a ceiling where the wires are strapped to metal pieces of the building, if there's damaged insulation, like you can see here, see there's bare copper right there. If that bare copper makes contact with the metal box, you'll hear the system start beeping that it's gone into ground fault. And the system is now indicating a ground fault, and once it's repaired, the ground fault will clear itself. Here is another system that is currently indicating a ground fault. It's got the ground fault light, and it's telling you it's got a ground fault. So what does that mean? There's a pinched wire somewhere leaking current to earth ground. If we come down and take a look at a device here, what had happened was this wire got connected around the screw and it damaged the insulation. Once the problem is fixed, we'll put some tape on that afterwards. The panel will go back to normal condition. The system restored to normal, and typically this does not happen instantly as soon as you clear the ground fault, so you need to be patient and double check things with your meter, which we will do very shortly. We'll go back to this system here, which is in ground fault again, so we'll take a look at a few things inside the fire panel. When you open it up, you see that there's wires in different areas of the control panel that leave the cabinet. And that ground fault is on one of these circuits, but you don't know which one and the panel is not telling you. Additionally, we see we have the power light lit, the trouble light lit, and the ground fault light. So in a moment, we'll try and isolate which circuit from the panel has the issue. So starting over here, that's auxiliary power output to power something outside the fire panel. These are notification circuits. NAC stands for notification appliance circuit. It could be on one of those circuits, and it could be on the signaling line circuit that goes to all the addressable detectors. Finally, this panel is equipped with a network card, and it could perhaps be on the network connections. Lastly, this is rare, but it can happen. The bottom side of a battery can get damaged, and it could be metal-to-metal contact on the bottom of the fire alarm panel. Usually that can be determined by lifting the batteries and inspecting the bottom. The first step in troubleshooting is getting some voltage measurements. So we'll get the meter out. You're going to take one lead and connect it to earth ground. I'm going to connect it to this screw right here, but that's a painted door, so I'm just going to do a continuity check, make sure that is a good earth ground connection. I can do that by just touching the back plane. I have good continuity there. So now switch your meter to DC volts, and let's get a measurement on the system negative, which this terminal here is our auxiliary power output. The negative wire, we're reading about 20 volts. The positive wire is reading about 7. So you write those numbers down. Those are the bad numbers. What we need to do is find out what is the proper voltage supposed to be when it's not in ground fault. Low-hanging fruit, the notification circuits aren't going to any control modules or smoke detectors. They're just going to horn strobes, things like that. So we can lift these off the terminals, and we'll double check our voltage here. Still have 19 on the negative and 7-ish on the positive. So that's not it. I'm going to pull this circuit here. I need to find an alternate place to measure because I'll have the terminal board off. The battery negative is another place we can get that. Now that's in trouble, so I'm going to acknowledge the trouble. So I'm going to pull my auxiliary power off. Check my readings again. I still have about 20 volts on the negative side, so we know that's not it. That's not what is causing the problem. We're going to put these back on for now. And the only circuit left that's leaving the panel is our signaling line circuit. So let's pull that off. I'm going to get troubles because my devices are no longer communicating with the panel. I pulled the wires off. Now we can take a reading again. There we go. Now our negative reference is a 2-volt pulse. Notice it's pulsing to 2 volts and then about 0, back to 2, and 0. Our ground fault light up here went out. We're no longer in ground fault mode. So we know our ground fault is now on the SLC. So the next step will be to troubleshoot that. Before plugging this back in and going out into the building to try to locate where the grounded wire is, make sure your meter switched to ohms. And we're going to take resistance measurements on this to earth ground. So one lead is on earth ground, the other lead. We're going to check our positive lead. We're reading about 10.8 ohms. Remember that number or write it down if you need to, because that's going to be important later. As you get closer to where the problem is, so our ground is on the red wire, the positive wire, because that's got the lower reading. As you get closer to finding the problem, that resistance measurement is going to go down. So if you hit a spot somewhere out there and you're 0.8 ohms, then you've gotten a lot closer to it, because wire has resistance. And depending on the gauge of the wire, it's a certain number of ohms per foot. Once you've identified the circuit leaving the fire alarm panel that has the ground fault, now you're going to have to walk away from the fire panel, go out into the building, look for that circuit, and try to pick a point somewhere in the middle, a halfway point, if you will. It's probably just going to be a guess. You pick yourself a halfway point. You're going to need to open the circuit and take some measurements. So we can take this detector out of the base. And I can check to make sure I've got a ground on this still. I had to extend a ground from a location because I have no ground available right here. So I'll hook one lead to earth ground. Switch my meter to DC volts. Reading on the negative, I have 20 volts. I know that's not a good measurement. what we're looking for is 2. So what we're going to do now, separate these wires. We've got 2 cables coming in. One of these cables has voltage on it that's going back to the fire panel. The other cable most likely will not have voltage on it because it's going away from the fire panel. So the first thing to do is identify which one of these cables goes towards the fire panel. So we're going to have to measure voltage. So there's no voltage on this one. This one goes away from the fire panel. This one has our SLC voltage, so this goes towards the fire panel. So now I've got a lead on negative. I'll put a lead on earth ground. There's my pulsing 2 volts, which is the normal state of the fire panel. So we know that the ground fault is further from this point. You can do a little walk around. These detectors are still blinking, so they have power, so that means they're towards the panel. This detector is no longer blinking, so that means it's further from the panel, so it's on these wires. So I would move to another detector in that direction, and you just repeat this process over and over again until you can narrow it down between a couple of devices. Once you do that, you might have to look above a ceiling, maybe there's a pinched wire. What we can do is double check that you have a ground. Make sure you didn't accidentally fix it just by wiggling wires around at this detector. Connect one lead to earth ground. And do a continuity check on the cable that goes away from the fire panel. And I'm reading 330K on the black. The red wire, the positive wire, 0.4 ohms. So there is definitely a grounded wire, and we're quite close to it. So the thing to do would be to put this back together, move to another location, take the same measurements, pay attention to what detectors are online and offline. If you have a computer hooked to the fire panel, you can typically, if you can remote into it, you can see what devices are missing, and that will tell you which way to go. We hope that you found this video to be helpful and informative. Please like and subscribe for more content.